Hi, my name is Dee. In this tutorial, I'll give you a quick overview of the Oracle B2C Service Connect REST API, which lets you use Representational State Transfer, or REST, to access resources on your B2C service site over HTTP. I'm going to construct a URL that targets a REST endpoint, and then use a browser to quickly see what's at that endpoint. You start with your site interface name, and then the path to what's called the launch URL, which is what you see here. The first part up to here is the path to the REST resources, then after that is the version number. That could be version 1.3, for example, but you can also just use the word latest here and automatically get the latest version. Next is the resource collection that you want. In this case, I'll try accounts. In general, the REST API follows the conventions of the Connect Common Object mode that are used throughout Oracle B2C service. But there are some minor differences here, such as the names of the object collections are plural and start with a lowercase letter like you see here. If I now execute this query by just navigating to this URL endpoint, notice that I have to authenticate because this is a secure connection. I'll get a list of all the accounts on my site, but without all the details of any individual account. But now if I add a specific instance, for example, the account object that has ID number 3, I can get more details on this object. What I'm seeing here is the raw response, which is formatted in JSON, or JavaScript Object Notation. When I'm executing a call like this in code, which is what I'd normally be doing, of course, not just typing it into a browser, then I could parse this JSON to get the values I need for my application. There's also a way to do a GET query, like this, that adds something like an SQL WHERE clause. For example, here I'll add this query string and query for name.last equal Griego. And you see my results, basic information and all the Griegos on my site. There are only two. Of course, while working in code, I'd be able to set the verb for the action I want to execute to something other than GET, which is what I'm getting here from a browser. So I could use the DELETE verb to delete an object, or patch to update it, or post to create a new object. That means you can do all of the basic object manipulations with the REST API, and you can also use the POST operation to create, that is run, an analytics report. Other videos from Oracle go into more detail on these options, and there are videos that show you how you can work with the REST API in several coding languages. But to get complete documentation, you can go to the online documentation here. There is specific information and examples for setting up the path to perform various operations available on various objects. So with the URL for your site in this documentation, you can now access the data on your Oracle B2C service site using REST in your application code. Thank you for watching.